Hello friends, and welcome to yet another episode of Eyelogues. And as you can see, all of this, the next few episodes is going to be about glasses, including the sunglasses. I get various questions today in the clinic. What does this prescription really mean? I have a cylindrical number, what's my axis? What's the right size of the frame for my head? What should be the lens that I should put in the frame? If I have reading glasses, what are my options? What are the options for materials of the frames? So next few episodes is going to cover everything about types of frames, materials of frames, glasses, lenses, coating for lenses, and of course, how to prevent your glasses from fogging. Today we all are wearing masks and we have to find a solution to the fogging. So what are the next few episodes is all going to be covering these topics. Hello friends, I'm Dr. Kumar Doctor from Dr. Eye Institute. This is a channel called Eyelogues. It's everything to do with eyes and eye health. If you are new to this channel, kindly subscribe this channel so that you get future notifications of the new videos that I release on a regular basis. Today's episode is all about glasses. There's a lot more to understanding glass prescription, so you can't even imagine how I'm going to get into the depth of it and describe to you the same. So let's get started for this first episode on glasses. So you've gone to your optometrist, to an optical shop, or you've gone to your ophthalmologist and you got a prescription for your glasses. Now you want to place an order for your glasses. So let us understand what that prescription actually really means. So I'm going to go into a depth of explaining to you how a prescription is really read and what it implies to when you make glasses. So when you see a prescription, the first thing to understand is OD and OS, which is written on the prescription. OD means oculus dexter, also means the right eye, and OS means oculus sinister, also means the left eye. OU means oculus uteric, which means both eyes. These are actually originally the Latin terms used for the eyes. I'm going to now show you a prescription and what it each individually means. The first part of the prescription is called the spherical number. Now, spherical numbers, as we all know, is into plus number or a minus number. So if it's a plus number, you are a hyperopic. If you have a minus number, you are a myopic, also called short-sightedness, also called near-sightedness. If you want to know more about vision, click the icon above, which will take you to my episode of what is normal vision. The spherical number is all to do with the length of the eyeball. If the length of the eyeball is longer than normal, the person or the patient would have a minus number, which is described here in the spherical column. If the length of the eyeball is shorter than normal, the person or the patient would have a plus number because the length of the eyeball is shorter. The second part of the prescription is called the cylindrical number. It also would have an axis. Cylinder is also called astigmatism, and it's all to do with the curvature of your cornea or your lens. The power that you see in the column below the cylinder is actually the power to correct that astigmatism and neutralize with that particular axis. There is one more part of glasses, which is called reading glasses. As we touch 40, a reading number would arrive, and this number keeps increasing till you are 60. It is also referred to as presbyopia, also called betala in Gujarati, and that means reading glasses. The reading number arrives at the age of 40 and it keeps increasing till you are 60. This actually happens because the lens inside the eye is not as accommodating as when you are 20 years of age. Now, you may have no glasses for distance at all. And then what you really need is a prescription. If you are 50, the reading glasses would normally be +2. If you are 60, the reading glasses would normally be +3. And this we call as the rule of the thumb. I'm now going to show you a variety of examples of prescriptions of glasses. The first prescription is for hyperopia, or a distance number, or farsightedness. As you can see in the prescription, the spherical number is +0.75. This is for the right eye. If you see the column in the left eye, the spherical number is +1.25. It only means that this patient's distance number is 0.75 in the right eye and a +1.25 in the left eye. The last column in this prescription is for vision. The vision written there is 6x6. That is for distance, and vision for near is N6. 6x6 only means that the patient has normal sight with this prescription. And N6, that means the patient can read the smallest letters possible with the glasses. Let us look at another prescription of myopia or nearsightedness, also called shortsightedness. In the right eye, the spherical number is 1.25 minus, and the cylindrical number is -0.75 at an axis of 90. That is written in the right eye column. And the left eye column says -1.75 with a -1 cylinder at 90. It only means that this patient has a spherical component of a minus number. That means the length of the eyeball is little longer than normal. And the curvature of the cornea of this patient is also not equal in both the axes. And that's the reason why this patient has a 0.75 cylinder at the axis of 90 in the right eye. So this is the description of a prescription for myopia where a spherical and cylindrical number has been prescribed to the patient. The last prescription in this series is for presbyopia, which is reading glasses. As the first column for the right eye shows that the near prescription is +2.5, and in the left eye, the near prescription is also +2.5. You can see in this prescription that the distance number is entirely zero in both eyes. That means that this patient has got only reading glasses and needs to make either progressive glasses or reading glasses which the patient can use for near work. It also means that the patient's distance vision is normal, 20 by 20 or 6 by 6, and does not need to wear glasses to see distance objects at all. For example, driving, television, movies, etc. So when it comes to manufacturing of glasses in the frame that you've selected, how will you know that your glasses are correctly made? So let me take you to an instrument called the lensometer. This instrument is called the lensometer. It's very simple. Put the frame in the lensometer and this display will actually display the number that is there in these glasses. This is the left eye and this is the right eye. So this way we can also check the interpupillary distance, that is the distance between the two eyes when the glasses are manufactured. Don't get confused and don't get stressed. I'll go into the depth of that terminology that I've used. It's called IPD. So once your glasses are made, there are two terminologies which are essential to understand if they're made okay. I introduce one terminology called the IPD. It's not very complex, it's very easy to understand. Interpupillary distance. The pupil is inside the eye. The distance between the two pupils is also called IPD. The next terminology I'm going to introduce is called centration. And this is very essential that the glasses are made properly. It means that the center of the glass should be matching the center of the frame, should be matching the center of the eye. If there is a problem at any level, the patient is not going to be happy with the quality of the vision that he gets with the new glasses. So, IPD also is given by your eye doctor as information to the optician to make glasses. There is a methodology to measure the IPD on a computer, and once the glasses are made, you can make a center part on each of the glass, and if you take a ruler and match from there to there, it will match your IPD. So the center of the glass in your frame on one side to the other side, when measured with a ruler, will actually equal your IPD, which is measured by the computer when you have your initial eye checkup. So for a correct prescription, make sure that your IPD is correct, which of course is the information given by your optometrist or by your eye clinic. Many times patients ask me, how will we know that the glasses are not made correctly? What actually happens is, if the centration is not correct, if your IPD is not correct, what happens is you still try to see. It causes a little bit of eye strain, and this may lead to headaches. And that's how you will come to know that there is some problem somewhere. At that stage, it's wiser to go back to your optician, just verify that it's correct, just verify that the prescription is matching, or you can go back to your eye doctor who can do exactly the same for you. So this brings to the end of our first episode all you ever wanted to know about your glass prescription, what it really implies, what it really infers, and the next few episodes is all going to be about frames, the lenses in the frame, sunglasses, and how to prevent fogging in this era of COVID.